Hi, I am Alexandra Barker. The Census Bureau released 2020 Census Apportionment Results. In this data gem, I want to show you how to easily access and visualize this data along with apportionment results from 1910 to 2020 using the Historical Apportionment Map. Let me show you how it works. To access the Historical Apportionment Data Map, visit Census.gov. You can use the search bar to locate the map. You can also visit the library and look for our census infographics and visualizations. Before we discuss the features on this map, let's talk a little bit about apportionment. Apportionment is the process of distributing the 435 memberships or seats in the House of Representatives among the 50 states based on the apportionment population counts from the decennial census. Article 1, Section 2 of the U.S. Constitution requires that a census of the population be taken every 10 years to apportion the seats in Congress. This interactive map includes historical data for each census between 1910 and 2020. It allows you to visualize data in so many ways. The default view for this map is the United States, but it allows you to access data for each of the 50 states. You can use the drop-down menu or just click on the state on the map. Whether you'll be making a comparison or looking at states individually, this map will show you the number of seats in the U.S. House of Representatives for each state, changes to the number of seats, and the population per representative for the U.S. for each state. And if you change to the population map, you'll be able to see the resident population of each state, the percent change in resident population, as well as the population density for each state. Now, let's check the features of the apportionment map. The default view shows data for the United States. You can use this map to see the change in seats, the states that gain or have lost a seat according to the 2020 Census apportionment results. You can use the left sidebar to choose a new decennial census year and see changes over time. You can also use the graphs on the bottom to see changes in seats as well as changes in population per representative in the United States over time. If you would like to visualize the same data for a specific state, you can use the map to select the state. I am going to select Massachusetts. Right away, you get relevant data for the state of your selection. In this case, you see the number of representatives, the change seats, and the population per representative for the state in the decennial census year of your selection. Notice that the graphs on the bottom also have changed to show data for the state of your selection over time. And if you like to visualize data for a new decennial census year for your state, you can select a new year from the bar on your left. However, once you click on the new year, your map is back to the default view of the United States. So you're going to need to reselect your state. If you would like to lock in the view of your state, you have to use the drop-down menu to make your selection. In this case, I will select Massachusetts again. Your map will go back to showing data for your selected state. But now you can change from one year to another while keeping your selected state as the default geography. Let's go from 2020 to 1980. You notice that Massachusetts is now the locked view on this map. Next, let's take a look at a population map. Once you click on population map, we are back to showing the default view of the United States. You can use this view to compare states and see how the population has changed in different areas of the country, including the population change by region between 2010 and 2020. You can also see how the population of the United States has changed over time. Now, let's look at population change for a specific state. I will select California. And if you would like to see the population density for California, you can switch from population change to population density. This map is now showing us the number of persons per square mile in each state. This map is interactive, and you can just move your cursor on top of it to see data for each state. But if you like to see data just for California, Look at the graph and you see the population density for California between 1910 and 2020. On the page of the map, you can also find some other useful resources. If you would like to access the data from the source table, it's available in one click for you. Here are the tables for population change, population density, and apportionment, as well as historical apportionment data in a CSV format. Right below, there are notes about the population map and the apportionment map, and other relevant information about the population in the United States and apportionment. If you'd like to share this map, just click on the share icon to get the embed code and the link to this visualization. This map can make it very easy for you to access and visualize apportionment results from each census since 1910. I hope you'll find it useful. For more videos like this, visit census.gov/academy and subscribe. Thank you.